Good morning, students. Today I am going to explain about the securing storage infrastructure in virtualized environment under the module 5. Okay, here like how we are going to protect the informations from the unauthorized persons. And what like all the informations. Like how we are going to securing the by using the different platform. Okay, that platform should be a virtual platform or it may be a cloud platform. And what are the security levels? Okay, we are going to use this here. Okay, then like basically we are going to use for the network security level as well as the computing security level. The computing security level, which is nothing but what are the physical like devices or like resources, okay, which we are going to use for protecting the data in the cloud as well as the virtual environment. So this is what this module 5. Good morning, students. Okay, today I am going to explain about the securing the storage infrastructure in virtualized as well as the cloud environment, means how we are going to providing the security of security for the exact information or right informations of the right persons in the cloud or as well as the virtual environment. Okay, for that, okay, we are going to use for the different implement or different services or different methods. Okay, that is one is security concerns and second one is security measures. Okay, in the security concerns, okay, we are going to talk about the different levels. Okay, what is the security concerns and in that what are the sub levels we are going to maintaining, means okay, first one is multi-tenants and then information assurance as well as the data privacy, then velocity of the stack. Okay, so we will see, okay, what are the multi-tenants. Okay, the multi-tenants, okay, they are going to use for the multiple tenants. Okay, independently they are going to use for the same set of resources. See, so in that, okay, say for that they are going to call it as the multi-tenants. I am repeating, the multi-tenants, okay, they are going to use for the individually for the same set of resources in the cloud. That we are going to call it as the multi-tenant. The second one is security assurance. Yes, the security assurance, okay, they are going to provide for the information confidentiality, authentication, accountability, the availability. These all are the security assurance, okay, which we are going to providing for the right person for the right informations. Then what is the velocity of the stack? Okay, velocity of the attacks, okay, which is nothing but whatever the information means the existing informations, okay, they are going to impact for the large amount of data, okay, in the cloud environment. Then finally, what is the data privacy? Okay, data privacy, which is nothing but, okay, we are going to provide the privacy of the exact person, means the authorization persons. For that, okay, for authorizations data, we are going to provide the data privacy. The second one is security measures. Okay, the security measures, okay, we are going to implement it, okay, different computing levels. Okay, I mean different security measures. Okay, that is one is compute level, network level and storage level. Okay, these three level, okay, how we are going to measure the security. The first one is the security at the compute level. Okay, the security at the compute level, which is nothing but, okay, what are the platform, okay, what are the environment, okay, we are going to use for the security measures. One is for the hypervisor, then virtual machine platform as well as the cloud platform, then for the guest operating systems. Okay, these all are the, okay, different platforms or different environments, okay, which we are going to use for the securities. Then the next one is security at the networks. See, sorry, like in the compute level, okay, I told right that for the like physical server as well as the virtual machine, then hypervisors, then like different guest operating systems. Then what is the physical server? See, the physical server security, okay, they are going to implement it for the user authentications as well as the authorization mechanisms, okay. Based on that, they are going to identifying the users and like they are going to provide the privileges for the privileges for the physical servers. Then what is the hypervisor? Okay, the hypervisor, okay, which is nothing but a single point of security failures for the virtual machine that can be running on it, okay. And then the middleware installment, okay, on the hypervisor, okay, they are going to make for the detection for difficulty for the difficulty for the software as well as the hardware installations in the guest operating system. So this is what the different like computing levels, okay, we are going to use for the security measures. Then what the next one is, what is the network layer? See, the network level, okay, here we are going to use for the firewalls as well as the detection means like intruder, like from malicious attacks, okay, they are going to fetching the informations, okay, without permissions or without authorization permission of, okay, if anybody have to fetch that particular information. So we are going to use for these network layer. Means what I am going to tell them means, okay, if any unwanted things or any unwanted data, okay, which we are going to use in the cloud, okay, that we have to overcome that problem, okay, we are going to use for the network levels. Then the storage levels, okay, if like all the data, okay, finally we have to stored in one of the storage disk or it may be a storage cloud, okay. In the storage level, okay, we are going to use as the has a database or it may be a storage disk or it may be a storage array, okay, like that, okay, we are going to copying the data or we are going to storing the data, okay, once we have to read as well as write on the particular data, finally we are going to store on that particular disk, okay. And whenever we want that particular data for the authorization person, okay, based on their login credential, okay, they can access and they can read the data, but we cannot write that data once again, okay, means we cannot modify the data, okay, just we can access and we can fetch the data from the database. See, this is the this is what the permissions or which is what the authority of that particular person having, okay. See, these all are the security measures, okay, we are going to use for the cloud environment as well as the virtualized environment. Then I'll move on to the next one is, inter-array storage tiering, okay. In the inter-array storage tiering, okay, here we are going to use for the two types of tiering, that is tier 1 we are going to consider as the primary storage and tier 2 we are going to consider as the secondary storage, okay. And based on the policy engine, they are going to the data movement, okay, between the tier 1 and tier 2, okay, everything they are going to stored in the policy engine. Means the policy engine, okay, they are going to take care for the tier 1 data as well as the tier 2 data, okay. The tier 1 data, primary storage data, means whatever the primary data, okay, they are going to copy in the secondary storage, okay, or it may be tier 2. Here the tier 2, okay, they are going to work as the backup data or it is a backup device, okay. See, the applications or it may be a client, okay, they are going to fetch the fetch the data, or it should be retrieve the data from the policy engine, okay. Directly they cannot able to access the data from the policy engine, okay, through any one of the network, or it may be a LAN or it may be a WAN, okay, any one of the network, okay, they can able to access the data in the inter-array storage tiering. see, this is about the storage tiering of the second method. Okay, thank you.